As of November 24th of 2025, there are currently 42 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 2 more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes is Hawaii's famous Kilauea Shield volcano, which on Saturday morning produced a series of strong gas-pistoning events with small lava flows. Kilauea has been producing episodic activity confined to its summit caldera since December 23rd of last year, with each episode ending in hours-long periods of tall lava fountains. The 37th episode of lava fountaining could have already occurred or begun before this video was published, being possible between November 22nd to 26th, but most likely between November 23rd to 25th. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, the Sangeang Api volcano showed new and significant signs of unrest. This led to evacuations and a decent potential that it could newly erupt in the near future. Meanwhile, in Ecuador, magma may have recently intruded underneath the Galapagos volcano known as Fernandina, leading to an earthquake swarm that even involved a magnitude 4.7 quake. And in what is this week's top story, a major and destructive eruption occurred at Indonesia's Semeru volcano, leading to several hundred degrees Celsius pyroclastic flows reaching as much as a whopping 17.4 kilometers or 10.8 miles downslope. This eruption began on November 19th when heavy, localized rainfall seeped into Semeru's unstable summit lava dome. The rainwater then flashed to steam, built in pressure, until it finally exploded upwards, breaking apart the hot material in the lava dome, which largely collapsed back to the ground as the pyroclastic flow. The first pyroclastic flow at 2:13 p.m. traveled only 5 kilometers, but across the next 2.5 hours, 4 more explosions occurred which generated longer and longer pyroclastic flows until the largest explosion occurred around 4:50 p.m. This generated the longest 17-kilometer-long pyroclastic flows and surges, which not only impacted the Gladak-Perak Bridge, causing burn injuries to people on it, but seemingly spilled over the sides of the river channel in some spots, destroying or damaging dozens of structures. Afterwards, a destructive lahar spilled over sections of the riverbanks, destroying additional structures. While preliminary and unconfirmed, as many as 197 structures may have been damaged or destroyed, with damaging pyroclastic flows, surges, or lahars reaching an area of up to 16.74 square kilometers or 6.46 square miles. Thankfully, there were no fatalities. The vast majority of the pre-existing summit lava dome was destroyed by this eruption, and weaker eruptive activity has occurred since. Overall, this eruption probably rated on the 0 to 9 volcanic explosivity index as a low N3, even with its tall eruption plume. Meanwhile, 678 kilometers or 421 miles to the east, new activity occurred at a different Indonesian volcano, specifically Sangeang Api. Since mid-October, the number of volcanic earthquakes at this island's stratovolcano, which has not erupted since 2022, has been elevated. Then, on November 21st, continuous ground rumbling was heard for multiple hours, and while this would stop, it was followed by a change on an unexpected part of the volcano. Specifically, gas emissions began to newly rise at a spot 2.2 kilometers away from the closest of the volcano's 2 main craters. In my opinion, it appears that either a batch of magma has risen or a volume of gas, and soon this volcano could produce a new eruption. As a result, Sangeang Api's alert level was raised and an exclusion zone was declared, which was as follows, resulting in evacuations. And, in Ecuador's Galapagos Islands, ground deformation was potentially detected at the Fernandina volcano. As stress built up, it eventually led to an earthquake swarm on November 16th and 17th that involved dozens of quakes, including a magnitude 4.7 event at 11:06 p.m. on the 16th. While I could not 100% confirm this, it appears as though these quakes largely occurred on the volcano's ring faults, possibly due to ongoing volcanic uplift, which could be due to an intermediate depth intrusion of magma. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 23rd of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel members and patrons on Patreon for supporting my work.